There are a lot of people on YouTube who claim to know exactly what is coming with Elenin in 2012, whatever. We speak now to those people. You do not know anything about what our imminent future holds, and neither do we, and neither does anyone else here on YouTube. I'm talking about the people who speak with such certainty, such righteous indignation, to proclaim that they somehow have the answers. And you do not. Are we talking to the doomers, the fearmongers? Yes, of course we are. But also to those who say things like, Elenin is a dwarf star, or everything electric will be gone in a flash. Of course, those things might very well be true. But you have all noticed when a video crosses that line between offering a theory and making bold assertions about stuff they could not possibly know. You have all seen the comments that walk right past dissent and straight into hatred. At this point, your mind has already figured out the point we are trying to make, so we'll move on. Precognition, advanced warning of Elenin, those are hopes out of our reach. But some things are not. We do have a lot of pieces to the puzzle. The following is what we believe are the most relevant Elenin facts, accompanied by various speculations and theories that have been proposed along the way. This account is by no means an all-inclusive dissertation. All theories presented are theories. Please do not take our word for any of this. Do your homework. Make your own conclusions. For most people, the Elenin journey began with the alignments. If you don't know what I'm talking about, how did you find this video? All we'll say is that you should go compare the major earthquakes and the alignments with solar activity. Solar Watcher's channel is essentially a comprehensive account of recent sun activity. It got weird for a lot of folks when we realized that Leonid Elenin, the finder of the comet, has the most coincidentally prophetic name ever, even before you realize what he found and when it's coming. Here's the short version. Leonid, his first name, is the name for a November meteor shower. If you break his last name into ELE and NIN, ELE is widely known to be extinction level event. NIN has had many speculative meanings, and you can look them up pretty much anywhere. Our favorite is a Sumerian meaning, meaning goddess priestess from the stars. And this guy found a comet that will be here this fall, and that has at least one coincidence with dire earthly consequences. The trolls and debunkers still had us at this point, though. They said, if this thing is so big to cause earthquakes, why can't we see it? We cannot say for sure who first tied Nibiru and a dwarf star into this Elenin mix, but such a dark object might explain why Elenin was invisible to us. Quick FYI, both Elenin and Nibiru both allegedly have 3,600-year orbits. Also, it has been about 3,500 years since a great deal of evidence found in the rock and in the ice suggests that we had our last major worldwide flood or a block out of the sun, you know, sort of major event. And lastly, it does appear that the Mayan calendar unmistakably either ends or changes phases in the coming months. Now back to our allegedly invisible comet Elenin. Someone remembered that we had infrared telescopes, which would be able to see this otherwise dark object. On Google Sky, there's an overlay from IRAS in infrared, but it was last updated in 2007. So it was a matter of using NASA's data to determine Elenin's coordinates back in 2007. Total long shot. Except that it showed something that people said was a dark star, black hole, etc. One thing's for sure, we couldn't believe that that is what came up when we plugged in the coordinates. Here's the thing. That object allegedly is a carbon star called CW Leonis, documented and really, really far away. Now, either that's actually Elenin, and C.W. Leonis is a cover story, or NASA is pointing us in the wrong direction, or this is one heck of a coincidence. Moving on. That name, Leonid Elenin, There's more to it than just what it might mean. Did you see Deep Impact? Most of you know the basics of this, so we'll keep it short. The kid named Leo finds Comet ELE. Part of it ends up hitting the Earth. There's a black president dealing with a financial crisis, and the heroes ride Shuttle Atlantis on what could be humanity's final flight. That ties five coincidences pretty much back to our discussion so far. And did you know that the year that came out, 1998, NASA kicked off the Deep Impact project that ended up hitting a comet with a projectile? That's two more, thanks to MR2 for that last bit of info. In addition to the 3,600-year cycle, there is another numerological coincidence. Elenin will be the closest to the sun on 9/11. This is a minor coincidence, except that there is a twist to this element of the puzzle. If you didn't know that NASA has been changing the JPL diagram, how did you find this video? Essentially, in the original diagram, the comet dipped below Earth's orbital plane on January 1st, 2001. 1-1-1. This was supposed to be the closest to the sun on 9/11. That's still true. However, in the old diagram, it was also supposed to come back up through Earth's orbital plane on 9/11. Perigee is now the only coincidence that remains. For a full explanation of that, you can check our previous videos. There's more than one of them. Okay, so for a quick replay, we have alignments with earthquakes and solar activity, the name Leonid Elenin, Deep Impact, kid named Leo finds ELE, blah blah, NASA project, Deep Impact hits comet, the dark object, numerology. Then NASA started messing with us. While many, including us, were cheering the stereo B-roll that is allegedly showing the world a picture of something that she hasn't seen for a long, long time, we were happy to see a healthy amount of, well, why would NASA do this? Didn't they say this thing was small and insignificant? And haven't they been politely calling us crazy this entire time? Considering that the article NASA released about a potential catastrophic solar event by 2013, combined with recent record-breaking CMEs, you would think that NASA would want that expensive device looking at the sun, like it's supposed to be doing. Do you remember NASA telling us that on its brightest night, if there were clear skies, you might see Elenin if you had a good pair of binoculars? Now the coma is bigger than Jupiter? You know it's going to be closer to us than Venus, right? According to NASA. Why didn't they think we'd be able to see it? How big do you think they're going to say this thing is next week? How about in October? Coincidences, NASA changing its story, and some people think they have the answers? Here's an idea. Every night, starting right now, if it's clear, go out and try to see Elenin. For a general sky reference, see our Elenin video from August 4th. Check the stereo B images just to remain informed. That's another thing. We hear a lot of this, why trust NASA? Don't use the JPL, they're lying to you. Being awake involves not only alternative views, but the mainstream. To understand the message, to understand your neighbors and your friends, to understand what's going on in the minds of some of your own family members. But go out and look for Elenin. Pretty soon it will be a noticeable light trailing the sun down under the horizon. Then, around September 27th, the tail will come up just before the sun, and will thereafter be visible earlier and earlier, and with greater luminescence until the middle of October. Hopefully the upcoming changes do not prevent everyone from watching her fly away. I can hear it now. What changes? Is he about to spread fear? No. But realize that comets can break up as they slingshot around the sun. The coincidences surrounding this thing are numerous, and very, very difficult to reconcile. Realize that volcanoes and earthquakes and flooding and extreme temperatures are setting records across the entire world. Remember that all of your various religions have the same flood stories, and ancient non-religious writings bear similar stories. Nibiru may be real, and may be here soon. Elenin may be a 3-mile-wide magnet that flips our poles, or worse. it might block out the sun. One thing is certain. If there is the type of event that many of you fear, realize that all of those stories are true to some extent, and that in each circumstance, someone was left to tell the story. As we said before, humans will be here to welcome Elenin back around 5600 AD. Have a healthy respect for humanity's ability to stare self-destruction in the face and win since the dawn of war, of power, of greed. All of the foregoing is the foundation of our current position. Be prepared for a serious emergency. Pay attention to Elenin, the news, and the Earth. Do not be afraid. Do not spread fear. Much love. Heads up, everyone. Be safe.